Guthrie America, and welcome to another segment of It's All About Guthrie. Well, we have had a wonderful 89er celebration here last month, and a part of that celebration, of course, was the rodeo on Saturday. A hugely successful rodeo that we had down at the Logan County Fairground. And so I hope many of you had the opportunity to get out and participate in it. I'm sure many of you have seen some of the other activities that are going on throughout the month at the fairground. And we are so pleased to have with us today Jerry Casey, who is one of the dynamic duo that has kind of taken on that project of having many, many activities at our Logan County Fairground throughout the whole year, right here in Guthrie, America. Jerry, welcome to
Thank you.
It's All About Guthrie. I'm doing really, really great. Jerry, can you tell us a little bit about how you got involved, first of all, how you got involved with the fairgrounds and putting on the great activities that you and your partner are putting on there?
My partner Brett Weld and I, we did a rodeo here years ago at 89ers and stuff, and then as the years progressed, us performing there, we just kind of took over being locals. And then we kind of progressed that into both being veterans, me a 30-year veteran, him being a Marine veteran. We started doing our focus towards rodeo and helping local veterans in the area. So we travel a lot.
What a great thing. Well, May is a big month for you. I know you're just coming off of April, coming off a really successful rodeo associated with the 89ers. But you got a lot of things going on in May too. Tell us a little bit about your May activities.
May activities are looking really strong this year. We're gonna have barrel racing on Wednesday night starting around 7 o'clock. And then from barrel racings, we go to a calf roping and breakaway roping after that. Looks like on Thursdays, Mayors, we're going to have team roping, which will consist of about 150 team ropers every Thursday night. We're looking at putting on a play day maybe at the end of the month of May, and maybe a little junior bull riding and stuff. So we're really packed down.
So now the junior bull riding, that's where I get involved.
Sure.
Is that my size?
You just volunteered. I'll put you top of the list.
Well, that sounds like a lot of activities that you have going on. And I know one of your focuses is to have constant involvement, not just once a month, but constant involvement, constant activities going on at the fairgrounds, bringing all of this into Guthrie. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir. We're trying to make it grow. The arena back in the older days used to be, you know, a real impact on the economy here, and we're trying to make it come back. We need a lot of help. We do a lot of things out there, you know, volunteer times, and if you haven't been out there lately, it's a lot of improvements, a lot of cleanup and razzle-dazzle stuff. We use a lot of the local businesses to help us out, and a lot of the organizations around here, like the ROTC, the FFA, you know, the Legion, the BFW to help us out, you know, get community involvement along with local small businesses so they can be a part and express how Guthrie is growing.
Yeah. Well, that's great. I know that for some of us, as we come out to an event or drive by and see an event going on, we see that activity, but there's a lot of things that go on behind the scenes to make that all happen. Just keeping the fairgrounds maintained, getting your stock in and feeding the stock and so forth. Tell us a little bit about some of the things that happen behind the scenes that we may not be aware of.
Well, we usually average just at the arena alone, it's an everyday affair that you got to feed the livestock, get it ready. You know, it works every weekend, so then, you know, you have doctoring and stuff, regular cowboy stuff you got to do. And then we brush hog and started painting the arena, started cleaning up the fence, repairing the fences and stuff, and started cleaning the timber lines. We've hauled off about 8 to 10 truckloads of stuff and debris that's been there, so we really cleaned up the grounds and made it official. The bathrooms just got updated. They're handicap accessible now. We got new toilets and a new sink in there. So that's some of the things that we do. It's kind of fun. And, you know, we kind of have been probing the master gardeners to come out and help put us in a flower bed so we can kind of spruce up a little bit of the facial there. Get
made. Well, we can. I'm sure that there'll be some flowers being planted pretty soon. Jerry, you mentioned you're a veteran, Brent's a veteran. I know you have a huge focus on veterans of Logan County, and much of the focus and proceeds actually from the from the various events. Go back to those veterans. Tell us a little bit about that veteran support program.
What we do here is we take the profits of what we established down there at the arena, and we give back to a local veteran. We find a veteran who is in need. Last year, the two veterans we helped out, one's house was totally burned down and demolished, and we helped bring him in and his son and help them with funds to help get their house restarted, to help get them stabilized till the insurance and everything kind of helped them out. Then we went behind the scenes and we helped find them builders and contractors and all to help build their house. And a lot of them contractors all came forth and helped them out at a lower rate because he was a veteran and we were helping out. Another veteran here from the VFW and also a member of the American Legion needed help with ramps at his house and needed sheetrock in his living room and kitchen. So we helped him with funds and also contractors and all to get that done at a lower rate. We try to focus on veterans in this area versus national organizations and stuff. We kind of keep it here, you know, and we try to choose Guthrie and choose Guthrie area people. So.
Well, that's a great mission. And certainly paying back to the community, paying back to veterans who give so much, have given so much to all of us. It's a great tribute to what you and Brent are doing. Now, I know you have, in addition to the activity in the arena, you also have some food trucks and possibly pop-up on the outside, pop-up retailers?
Yes, we have like local vendors like Up in Smoke, Parking Lot Party, a couple of guys do s'mores, stuff like that, a taco truck. They just come every week and then they set up outside the arena. So if you want to get something to eat or drink, or you can, you know, visit some of the restaurants here locally. There's some fine places to eat here and then come out there. You know, like I said, we start around 7:30 and gives you time to come to town, get you a good dinner, maybe walk around some shops and then come see us at the arena and relax.
Fantastic. Well, I know that there is a significant economic impact on our community, and it's growing obviously as the events get larger. Do you have a sense of what the economic impact is, Jerry?
I think with the arena and the programs that we're doing out there, I think we impact closely about $10,000 out there to the community and stuff, and we're growing every day. I'm getting calls about growing for next year. We're already planning some stuff for next year, so it's really helping us out around here.
So out-of-towners that are coming in and staying in hotels, of course eating at restaurants, visiting local shops, all of that contributing to that economic impact for every single event that you have.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Wonderful. You've mentioned the May activities. Do you have any other future activities that you want to focus on, you want to mention to our audience for the rest of the year?
Rest of the year, we're looking at putting on a couple of major barrel racings. We'll also in the fall, starting in August on Wednesday nights, we'll continue with the barrel racings and the roping. And then at the end of the year, last weekend of August, we'll do a professional rodeo, International IPRA, and it'll be a full rodeo and stuff on a Saturday night with a little bit of a ranch bronc twist to it for our local area, being some ranchers. And then that Sunday we have a what we call a barrel racing fraternity.
Great.
So we're looking really good.
Great family entertainment and good food.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and a lot of it going, again, to a good cause, helping veterans in our community, and doesn't get any better than that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you for being with us, Jerry. Just remember, it's all about Guthrie.